Alright, let's start. What is up, guys, and welcome to the Euros 2020, or maybe Euro 2021, however way you look at it. Welcome to my stream. Welcome to the football chat box. I have decided to play Euros 2020, the fantasy game. Initially, I wasn't sure whether I was gonna play it, but now I am gonna play it. But we're probably not gonna take it seriously. So, this is my draft team selection. So as you guys can see on screen, this was just an autocomplete team and this is what I got. But on stream right now, we are going to go and try and pick a draft team, initial first draft team, and then we'll probably do a few more videos where I will maybe give you guys updates based on how the team is going. So the whole idea of this, I want to try and do more live streams for everyone, to probably better engage with the community as well, to grow my channel. If you guys are new, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button if you're new. We're trying to get to 100 subscribers, hopefully, if possible, before the start of the FPL season. So let's start with my goalkeepers. So I haven't done much research on this. Yeah, okay. So I'm gonna probably pick it based on how the community is going at the moment, and then once I've done a bit of research, I might switch it up a bit. At the moment, obviously, the plan is that I'm gonna take it chill, the whole tournament in general. So we're gonna try and play a bit chilled, not too seriously, try and enjoy the Euros. That's the whole aim of this. So I'm gonna build a draft team that will be good for match day one. There are 3 match days. I'll probably pick a team for match day one, do the limitless chip in match day two, and then match day three it'll revert back to my match day one team. So let's try and focus on match day one, and try and get a decent team out. So right now, predictor. So we're looking at goalkeepers, which means we're going to look at most likely to keep clean sheets. Looking at Belgium, Courtois seems to be the one who's favored. And let's just confirm that because I know that Courtois and Belgium have a decent group. Can I get a fixtures over here? They have Russia date. Nah. It's only match day one that they show, right? Unless I click information. There we go. So yeah, Belgium have Russia, Denmark and Finland, which is not too bad. And I know that Belgium have kept quite a bit of clean sheets in their campaign towards the qualification of Euros. So I'm gonna pick him in defense, I mean goal. And in terms of a backup goalkeeper, who do we have? Is this like who's the most transferred in? Heredeki. Why Heredeki? Is Heredeki going to start? Is he a 4 million goalkeeper that's going to... Oh. Yeah, maybe. For Denmark. Donnarumma is another option for Italy. Italy also have been good in goal, but if I'm going to have one keeper, I'll probably go with Courtois. I'm most likely not going to sub anyone on, so I'll put Heredeki on there as my backup goalkeeper. Next up, let's go to defense. Let's get rid of that. Again, I want someone who most likely clean sheets. And Italy, from what I know, have a good group. They got Turkey, they have Switzerland, and they have Wales. And Italy, I believe they were one of the three teams that kept the most amount of clean sheets in their campaign. So I'm gonna pick Florenzi. I know Bonucci is supposed to be a sure starter. So the question is, do I want Bonucci or where is everyone? How do I get rid of this? Oh yeah, I click it. There's Bonucci who is selected by 5%. There's Spinazzola. He's also an option. I could go Spinazzola instead of Florenzi, but I do like the lack of Florenzi. He's very attacking as well, so I don't mind having him. The question is, do I go double Italy defense? That is a good question. Probably not really sure at the moment. I can't have three players from one team. So right now, let me just go Spinazzola for now. So double Italy at the back. Who else? Let's see. Let's go back to most likely with the clean sheet. So John Stones versus England. So what's England's? They've got Croatia, Scotland, and Czech Republic. Now England, I don't know. Like, I'm not too filled like in confidence with their potential to keep clean sheets, especially when like we're not sure who England's second centre back is going to be, or whether they're going to play a back three with two fullbacks in the back three. So I'm not sure about that. So I'm not going to touch England at the moment. Ruben Dias is there, and 42% have selected Ruben Dias. But again, that's because they're playing Hungary in the first game, and if you play limitless in match day two, you don't have to worry about Ruben Dias, and then he comes against France. So I can see why people, if you're targeting the first game, it's a good option to have Ruben Dias. The question is, let's target Portugal, shall we? If I was to target Portugal, and because they're playing Hungary, who else do we have? We have Pepe, Guerrero, Semedo. I'm going to go with Pepe instead of Ruben Dias, mainly because he's just that million cheaper. This is already a pretty expensive defense, and I'm probably going to only play three defenders, so we're going to have to try and get a few differentials in defense. So who did they give us? How do I get rid of? There we go. Lucas Hernandez, Ben Chilwell. Those are some very expensive differentials, don't you think? Let's go budget defenders. Sonichu against Turkey. Turkey have been good as well, but they're playing Italy on the first game, so I probably won't get Sonichu. Who is this? Pau Torres. Pau Torres is playing... Will Pau Torres start? He should, right? He's playing Sweden. How much is Pau Torres? 4.5. 4.5, I don't mind. Let's get him. And I need to pick one more. Who else? Budget defenders. Let's Smoots transferred in. Simon Kerr against Finland. Denmark against Finland. Yeah, why not? Another 4.5. To be honest, I have no idea who I'm picking at times. Some of these players I don't really know as much. I will have to do a bit of research. But I'm like picking based off like some of the favorites kind of. Or like what the community is going with at the moment. I just want to get a team out there, see what we have. Obviously, the forward line is where I want to target. And looking at the midfield as well, right? There aren't that many like suggested midfielders. Bruno Fernandes, playing for Portugal. I'm not really sure how we're going to do this. Because I'm looking at the midfield. It's not that great. Chiesa was one player I think a lot of people wanted. He is playing Turkey. I don't know what Italy's striking options are like. Hazard is there. Questions about Hazard's fitness. Joao Felix. Jack Grealish. I don't know who's going to start for England though. That's another problem. Ooh, that was the Sancho? Yeah, Sancho is also there. 9.5. Damn. That's a lot. Let's go to forwards first. Alright. Harry Kane is playing Croatia. To be honest, Croatia a decent team. Mbappe playing Germany. Probably don't want Cristiano Ronaldo playing Hungary. It's Cristiano Ronaldo. Robert Lewandowski playing Slovakia. What's Poland's chances of creating? But then Lewandowski is insanely good. I'm gonna have to think of this properly. DeepEye, I had some DeepEye of myself. Like, he's playing Ukraine. Netherlands, pretty decent team, but then again, doesn't fill me with confidence. Timo Werner against France, nah. Ciro Immobile for 10 million, probably not. Benzema, maybe, but not for the first game. Damn. I'm probably going to have to find some cheap option right there. Most picked as captain. So, Harry Kane, Lukaku, Belgium against Russia. Surely you'll want Lukaku in there. Yeah, definitely. Got to have him in. Now, the question is, I have 31.5 million to split among five midfielders. I'm going to have to reduce my. I'm gonna have to reduce this midfield slots a bit. Let's see. Bruno Fernandes against Hungary. Sh I need to target some, like, ooh, Gareth Bale. For 9.5 million, Gareth Bale against Switzerland. Ooh, very tempting. Very tempting indeed. Let's look at some budget midfielders. Mason Mount, I think Mason Mount is a good option. The question is, will Mason Mount start? That is the question right now. We'll see what happens. But before we pick our midfielders, if you guys are new, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. Another thing I want to ask you guys is, I'm taking part in a competition. And I need your help in terms of trying to win it. Let me get it up here. It's the road competition, and I've taken part as part of the football chat box. If you guys can go to this, I'll put the link in the description. Can you go here and click vote for me so that I can try and get better audio quality for you guys for the FPL podcast upcoming? So go ahead here, go to this link. Click vote for me, and we'll try and get some really good mics, hopefully, if we win this competition. I'll put the link in the description. Go check it out, guys. Go and give me a vote. Let's go back to our team. All right, so midfield. Yeah, Mason Mount, maybe. Let's put him in for the moment. I need to try and figure out my budget. How cheap are the midfielders? Surely. Sort by price. We can go all the way to 4 million. Uh-oh, that's too low. Yeah. Do I really want 4 million? No, I don't want. I ideally want to have a decent bench option as well. Let's sort by selected by. Why is this guy 42%? Is it because he's a 4 million player? He's playing Portugal. So long shots are, you do get an extra point for long shots. Bruno Fernandes loves a long shot. So I can see why people will select Bruno Fernandes, but he's 10.5 million and I don't think I have that kind of money. So I'm gonna have to pick someone else. We're going to go with Diego Jota. Ooh, he could play striker. I am interested. Let's go with Diego Jota for now. Tielemans does love a long shot as well for Belgium. Who else can we get? I have 16 million. I need three slots. That's not good. That is not good. So let's go back to budget. Shaqiri, Tielemans does is interesting. Suchek maybe. Kimmich, but he's playing France, so probably not. I need to get a 4 million player, right? Who's the most transferred in here? I'm gonna put this guy because I need a 4 million player. And then we're gonna get who can we get? This isn't easy, is it? Predicted top goal scorers. Oh, is this Ferran Torres? What is playing Sweden? 12 million, 6 million each, probably, at best. Or 8 million and 4 million. Potential penalty takers, Christian Eriksen. Gundogan. Could be. You do get points for penalties won, which means players who are likely dribblers is a good option. I don't have, interestingly, I don't have enough from England, which is very interesting. And I would predict England to go a decent amount. How much is the likes of Sancho? Who I can't afford by the looks of it. Kante. Now explain Germany, that's the problem, right? This is not easy. Let's pick Ferran Torres for right now. And then I need another 4 million player. So creative talents. No. That's not looking good. Budget midfielders. Not looking good as well. Sort by price. Let's get rid of that. Sort by price. And let's pick someone who is in the 4 million range. Who I have no idea who I'm picking. Surely I need someone better. I can't be doing this. Spinazzola of Firenze has to go. I already have a 4-point player. I can't have that front line, no. Can I? Can I? I just want that front line, but it doesn't look attainable. Sancho is 9.5. Joao Felix. Did I have Joao Felix? No, I didn't. I'm gonna have to split this like FPL team into like other groups as well. Who are the other groups that are there? France, Germany don't really want to target. This game I would like to target. Spain versus Sweden, potentially Poland, Slovakia, Scotland, Czech Republic. Scotland, Czech Republic maybe. Netherlands are playing Ukraine. Yes, I would love to target that game. Yeah, I think okay. Let's look at Netherlands. Who have we got that I haven't like really got anyone? I've got Depay, but I would l really like some. Ooh, they have a Quincy Promise. Yeah, here this is the thing. I can't get anyone else particularly because I have 4 million. Which means I'm gonna have to go and get someone else. So. Let's affordable players. Let's get rid of that. I have only three options. Oh my god. Okay, let's just put this guy on here. He's playing versus Ukraine. Let's go next. So at the moment, this is the team that's looking like it. I obviously definitely need to make changes to this team because like so I definitely need to make changes because my front line is very expensive. But then again, I have made the squad to be able to deal with the first game. I'm gonna have to change this up. We'll try and see who we can bring in, who we can change. We can play a couple of different formations, 4-3-3. 4-3-3, maybe potentially what I like to go with. I ideally like to go with a 3-5-2. Oh, actually, instead of a 3-5-2, I would like to go with 3-4-3, which means I need to get another midfielder in. I need to reduce a defender. I ideally would like to probably get rid of, maybe I might actually take Florenzi out, bring a cheaper defender in, upgrade this guy or this probably this guy to someone better in the midfield. We'll see how it goes. Right now, this is kind of what the team is looking like. In a 4-3-3. We'll see what happens with the team in terms of subs, etc. Sub out. It's very different. Let me know what you guys think. That's the team. Let me know who you guys have picked. We're gonna play for fun. Even though we're playing for fun, I'm gonna have to try and pick some better players, maybe have a better squad. The plan right now is go ahead with a good team in match day one, play limitless where I can swap it up a bit in match day two. Obviously, my match day one team has to be good enough to play match day two, match day three as well, so we have to take that into consideration. Thank you guys for watching. If you're new, hit the subscribe button. Go vote for me. Link will be in the description. If you come all up to this point, thank you for watching. Link's in the description. Go vote for me. We're trying to get a new set of mics. Thank you guys for watching. This is the team. I'll be back with another video, maybe on Wednesday for you guys, with a bit more of an update on my team. We'll see what's happening. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later.